I'm back with a new video, and this video is a little bit of a reading and a little bit of a scan. And I decided to use this box with cards because it has to do with angels and it's strongly infused with religious stuff. And you are very into Catholic things and going to church, and so this seemed to be appropriate in this case, in your case. Now you ask me about the angels that surround you. They are very impressive. It's like angels in the military. They are heavily armed and they are strong. They have a huge impact on the way you feel, the way you act, the way you find your way through life, in a good way, of course. No doubt about that, by the way. And I love these angels, but they are so, I don't know. They are big, they have an armor that glows both gold and pink, scarlet pink. Their wings are white pink, and they are guarding you like crazy. They make sure that you stay put, that you live your life where you are living your life. Now you are exactly in the right place. I already mentioned this in a reading I did for you before. Now about, how do I explain this? Soccer. If you live in the Netherlands or any other European country, soccer is a big deal. And when there is a important game, or you know, which start at, for example, 4 p.m., the whole city is already filling itself with supporters from both sides. This can lead to fights and riots and wars and a lot of violence and noise. And to keep things a little bit mellow and organized, they use police officers on police horses. Let's say there is a square, or you know, these horses march in and separate the crowd into that part and that part. The way they do it, they march through the streets in a row, and as soon as they bump into the crowd that is already, you know, charging each other, at least mentally, they create a boundary between these ones and that ones. And as soon as they create a boundary, the horses make this movement. So march in, and then they line up like this. And when the crowd, that part or that part, they want to charge and attack each other, they create sort of a, I don't know what it's called, boundary or a fence or something. And these horses are big and impressive and huge and strong. And it's the same with police dogs. And you don't want to mess with police dogs, and you don't want to mess with police horses. So I've seen them walking around you on horses, and I've seen them standing in line to keep you from crossing certain boundaries. And the horses aren't always there, but sometimes they are. That's how it looks from my side, the etheric astral. So they are huge and impressive. There are at least 7 in charge, and there is another group that sort of follows orders and do the smaller stuff. I have to talk to you about something else, which was really crazy. But I'm not going to do this in this video. So let's see. That's the Dutch way to say it. 43. In the Netherlands, we start with the second number and then the first one. So in English, it's the first number and then the second one. 43. Jovial. With God's help, I will receive inner wisdom. So before you dive into the Bible, for example, try to connect with this angel and find the wisdom inside instead of trying to dive into external sources. This is also a good one, I think. 40, the angel for goddelijk, divine power. With God's help, I will receive divine power. That's yours. And as for the angels, I know you're very interested in them, but it's in your case a lot about faith, I think, number one. In faith and trust, I know that everything in my life has a purpose and reason. So that's yours. And this is the last one I will pick, because that's enough. I will learn to express my true feelings. And you know, I know you are a little bit of a clown and you're funny as hell, but I think there's more to you being a clown and being funny, and you have a great sense of humor. Don't not lose that, because you are not always in a happy place, but, and you know, good sense of humor is a lifesaver. So keep being funny, make yourself laugh, because it's important. So that's a thing. And then there were these angels. That's weird. If I look at you, there are these seven, one in charge are on your left side, my right side, your left side, and the other ones are just, you know, it's a big group. It's at least 40 or 45 of these smaller angels. They are literally smaller. When I look at them, they are smaller, but these seven are really impressive. So maybe I should check again in about a week or so, see if something has changed. But you are in the right place and you have to do what you have to do. And you got a couple of warnings already where these angels didn't like you crossing certain boundaries, and I don't know. Most of the time they will sort of be invisible to you, and they will make sure that you do the things that you have to do without, you know, getting in trouble, but they're strong. So not much news, I think. That entity, that's just, I don't know, it's not something they worry about. So it's not something, I think, like a devil, an old-fashioned devil. To me, there's a difference between a demon and a devil. I will get into that in a future video, but not right now. A devil is something else than a demon. You have several types of demons with a certain hierarchy. This is Not even a devil, it's just something or somebody, it's a man, it's a male. It sits in a chair and it's relaxed. And so it reminds me of a grandfather or something that's just sitting in a chair at a fireplace with a newspaper in his hands. And it's an old-fashioned newspaper made out of paper with black letters and a few pictures. So I don't think there's something to worry about. He looks a bit black and white-ish. There's not much color to him. And normally this is because they have a very strong idea about what is wrong and what is right. That's when entities show themselves as black and white. He is white like you, but dressed in a white shirt with a black, some kind of, you know, these male vests things. Black trousers, white socks, white, you know, these elastic things that you can plong, boom, to keep your pants up. So he's quite an old guy, I think. But I will just upload his message and talk to you later. See you next time. Bye.